Dear students, today in this class I am going to explain how to find magnetic induction due to a solenoid. First of all, this is the solenoid. What do you mean by a solenoid? Solenoid is nothing but a long coil. This is a long coil. It is called solenoid. Okay, I am going to find magnetic induction due to the solenoid in three cases. Field at a inside point, that is, at any inside point, I am going to find magnetic field. Field at an axial end point, this is the axis of the solenoid. I am going to find magnetic induction at one end of the solenoid. Point number three, field at the center of the solenoid of finite length. If you consider a solenoid of finite length, I am going to find magnetic induction at the center of the solenoid. Okay, in three cases, I am going to determine magnetic induction due to the solenoid. Now, consider the figure. This is the solenoid. It is having capital N turns. Its total length is L. So, number of turns per unit length, small n is equal to capital N by L. Okay, number of turns per unit length. This solenoid is carrying a current I. Now, this is the axis of the solenoid. This is the axis. P is any point on the axis and inside the solenoid. At the point P, I am going to find magnetic induction. For this, you imagine the entire solenoid is divided into a number of small coils. You imagine one such a coil. See here, this is the coil. Its name is AB. Its width is DX. Okay, so how many turns it is containing? Number of turns per unit length is small n. Its width is DX. So it is containing NDX turns. Am I right? It is carrying this small coil, we have imagined, is carrying a current I. So, what is the magnetic induction at the point P due to this small coil? That is given by dB is equal to mu naught ni r a square. Mu naught n means ndx, I, a means its radius. Here, the radius of the solenoid is small a. So, a square by 2 into a square plus x square whole power 3 by 2, where x is the distance of the point P from the coil we have imagined. Okay, this is the distance x. So, dB is equal to mu naught n dx I a square by 2 into a square plus x square whole power 3 by 2 Tesla. Right. See the triangle ABC. If this angle is theta, automatically this angle will be theta. See here, if this angle is theta, automatically this angle will be theta because these two are parallel lines and this is the transversal. So, take sine theta. Sine theta is equal to opposite side AC by hypotenuse AB, AC by AB. That is R d theta by dx. Okay, then what is dx? R d theta by sine theta. From this you can get this. Okay, dx is equal to R d theta by sine theta. Right. Now from the triangle APO, see here, this is the triangle APO. Right. This distance is x. This is radius, that is a. This distance is r. Then from Pythagoras theorem, r square is equal to x square plus a square. Am I right? Now I am proceeding. Substitute all these values in this equation. dB is equal to mu naught n dx I a square by 2 into a square plus x square whole power 3 by 2. Instead of dx, I substitute all this r d theta by sine theta. And instead of a square plus x square, I substitute r square. Okay, Here I am going to substitute dv is equal to mu naught n. I don't write dx. Instead of dx, I am writing r d theta by sin theta, okay, into ia square by, I don't write a square plus x square. Instead of a square plus x square, I substituted r square. Okay, now it becomes mu naught n r d theta ia square by, this will become 2r cube sin theta. Okay, now continuing, this is the next step. This is a square and 1r gets cancelled, so a square by r square here. Okay, now see the diagram. Sin theta is equal to a by r. Here see this p, see this triangle. What is sin theta? Opposite side, that is a, hypotenuse. This is nearly equal to r because this distance is r. This distance will also be equal to r because the width is very small. So it is a and it is r. What will be sin theta? A by r. So sin theta is equal to a by r. Substitute here. Then a square by r square will become sin square theta. Okay, 1 sin theta gets cancelled and dB is equal to mu naught ni by 2 into sin theta d theta. Right? Now next, see here. You can imagine these coils from first turn to last turn. If you imagine this coil at the first turn, the angle made by the coil at the, that is the angle subtended by the coil at the point P will be theta 1. If you imagine this coil at the last turn, the angle will be theta 2. So to find total magnetic induction due to entire solenoid, you have to integrate the above equation in between the limits theta 1 and theta 2. So B is equal to integral dB from theta 1 to theta 2. Am I right? Is equal to mu naught ni by 2 integral sin theta d theta from theta 1 to theta 2. What is integral sin theta d theta? It is nothing but minus cos theta, theta 1 to theta 2. After substituting, you will get B is equal to mu naught ni by 2 into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. This is the magnetic induction at the point P due to entire solenoid. Right. Now, see here. At any axial point P, when it is well inside a very long solenoid. See here, P is axial point. It is well inside the solenoid. For this, theta 1 is equal to 0 because theta 2 is equal to pi. This is the first turn. If it is a very long solenoid, this angle theta 1 will be 0 degrees. What about theta 2? For a long solenoid, see here, I am going to draw. This is the solenoid. This is the point P. If it is very long, theta 1 will be nearly 0. If it is so long, theta 2 will be nearly 180. Am I right? So for a very long solenoid, theta 1 is equal to 0, theta 2 is equal to pi. Substitute here. Then cos 0 minus cos pi. What is cos 0? 1 minus. What is cos pi? Minus 1. So this will be B is equal to mu naught ni. Okay. This is the magnetic induction at any axial point inside the solenoid. The solenoid is very long. Okay. Field at an axial endpoint. See here. This is the endpoint of the solenoid. For this, theta 1 is 0. And what is theta 2? See the figure carefully. Theta 2 is equal to 90 degrees. Substitute. It will be cos 0 minus cos 90. So is equal to 1 minus 0, B is equal to mu naught ni by 2. This is the magnetic induction at an axial endpoint. Okay, now I am going to find the last case. This is the solenoid, but it is not having very long length. It is a solenoid having finite length. Imagine the point P here. P is the point at the center of the solenoid. Then what is cos theta 1? Cos theta 1 is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. That is L by 2 by root of a square plus L by 2 whole square. Okay, simplify this. Then cos theta 1 is equal to L by root of 4a square plus L square. Am I right? Now, what is theta 2? This will be theta 2. So, see the figure carefully. This angle will be pi minus theta 2. Take cos pi minus theta 2. Adjacent side by hypotenuse. L by 2 by this length will be root of a square plus L by 2 whole square. Then simplify this. Substitute this cos theta 1 and cos theta 2 values in the above equation. That is in this equation. In this equation. Okay. You will get B is equal to mu naught ni by 2 into L by root of 4a square plus L square plus L by root of 4a square plus L square. After simplifying, you will get B is equal to mu naught ni by 2 into 2L by 4a square plus L square whole power half. This is just half. Okay. Next. Next, B is equal to mu naught ni capital ni by 4a square plus L square whole power half, because you know small n is equal to n by L. So capital N is equal to nL. So instead of small n into small L, I substituted capital N. So B is equal to mu naught ni by 4a square plus L square whole power half. This is the magnetic induction at the center of a solenoid having finite length. In these three cases, I determined magnetic induction due to a solenoid. Okay, right.